This week's Saturday Session Specials coming up now with a track from this called The Promise.
It's a great writer.
There it was. It wasn't The Promise. It wasn't The Promise. So thank you to Angela Sharp, who told me that it was. It was, in fact, Diablo. El Diablo. Yes, that was it. From So Red the Rose. There you go. More from Simon and Nick a bit later on. Now, our audition news. The talent team had their work cut out last week, auditioning all the talented people in South.
Last two layabouts just crawled in from the street here. The first one is Level 42. It's the single which is around at the moment. This is Leaving Me Now.
It seems true love is so rare. Seems all I've known is to see. Your laughter fills the air. Once more I'm sensing.
Level 42 and Leaving Me Now. Right, we'll start with Tim Pope, having directed Bonnie's video. What do you think of that video?
I thought it was very emotional, very straightforward. I like the Robert Smith impersonation there with the lipstick. I thought that was very good. I like that. I thought that was very good. So I liked it. Fabulous.
Good. Bonnie?
I like the song and
Like the video?
Well,
not better than ours.
No, it's not better than ours, but
I
like the song, yeah, probably the hit song, but not so much the video.
Jimmy, you're smiling.
I prefer Bonnie Tyler, I think she's great. I like the song though because I think you could understand the words, and there's not many songs that you can understand the words now because they're just a mumble jumble.
Mumble jumble?
Mm-hmm.
Right, Ian, what about you?
I like Max Miller's suit. No, I liked it. I liked the vocal. I think the video was kind of exciting, but I like to cut the vocals.
I liked it when he was in pain, when he took off his makeup.
They're a good band, though, Julian, aren't they? Level 42.
Yeah, I really liked it because it was really simple. I think it's good with some of the videos now. They're getting back to being more simple, and it just used to be production. But it made the points very clearly. It's great.
Right, Alvin.
Well, I think some bands spend so much money on videos. Not mentioning any names. I like to hear the song. I really like to, sometimes it will be that you're confused
But there are a lot of programs now, I'm putting this one included, that there is a need for video, and if you say, well, if we've got a video, we can have it on this program, this program, this program.
But so don't you really think if it's a good band? I mean, Level 42 are a great band. There's some great bands. I mean, the lads are great. It's a good band. Sometimes it worries me why they have to go to all that trouble.
I promise, I'll never make any more
videos. I know it's the new scene, you know, you've got to have good pictures, haven't you, as well. It's the standard you're aiming for, I suppose. I like the band anyway. Great video.
Yes. Right.
I mean, great record.
Yeah.
That's where you're up.
Simon, this is my turn, right?
It's your turn.
Okay, Alvin, let's have this out right here and there.
The video, yeah, I like it. It's dead simple. It does focus your attention on the music, and that's something we're starting to do a lot more now. I want to stick up for videos a little bit. A lot of people say, well, if you play good music, you don't need to make a video or do anything like that. I mean, we're living in a... We're working now in an industry where you do need to do that. You have to be competitive.
Yeah.
If you don't, you fall behind. And a lot of people who just can't be bothered to really come up with that, you know, the ideas and put the enthusiasm in, start complaining about it. I think you've got to be realistic and see how it stands.
Okay, good point, Nick.
I thought it was all right, but I thought it was a bit boring as well. I mean, it's... I agree that it's nice to have some simple videos, but I think that... It's just a bit wishy-washy. I think it would have been nice if there were some other ideas in it. I quite like the song, though, and I think he's a great bass player.
So no chance for your Hooter on this
one? Not for this one, but I'm saving it for something that I know is coming up.
Right, Tim Furness.
Well, thumbs up for the song, thumbs down for the video. I thought the video was a bit unoriginal, really, but I like the song very much. I like the drumming as well.
Maybe with your help, some more space videos, maybe.
Yeah, why not?
Look at that. The first video on the moon. Junior?
Yeah. I like both. I like the song. I think the song's straight to the point, right? And the video is just very simple, right? And I like simple videos opposed to everything going all over the place.
Good. So on the whole, a bit of one of those. Right, the second one is Dream Academy. And the Smiths number, please, please, please let me get what I want. Right, Dream Academy, please, 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 let me get what I want, Junior.
What can I say? I think the video is very 60s, you know, going around, it's like the acid type thing. The song, Smiths, I prefer the Smiths version than their version. It's okay, it's not really my kind of thing, though.
Tim, your kind of thing?
Not really. I like the video. I thought it was really very artful. I like that very much indeed. But the
artful.
Song was probably pretty
inimitable,
I think.
The artful video.
Yes, why not? New word.
Nick?
I kind of like it, actually. I think it's good. Thank God for that. I think the song's really nice. I didn't know it was a Smith song until somebody just told me, being ignorant like that. But I think the video was kind of nice for it, too. I like candles and...
The group weren't actually too happy with the video themselves. They weren't very keen. Simon?
I like it. I like the song very much indeed. I've always liked the song. I couldn't really balance out which version I like the most, because I've only heard this one a few times. Mm-hmm. I like it a lot. I think the video is great, and obviously didn't spend too much money on it.
Right. What about that video, Arvin?
Yes, I think same.
Yeah. You like it?
You said be quick this time. So I said yes. Your turn.
Well, it made me feel sick, actually, because...
the bucket, please.
No, it starts off all right. It's a great atmosphere and a nice song, but, I mean, watching the whole thing, everything going round and round and round... I suppose you remember
concept
it.
In videos.
You do remember it.
Yeah. So they didn't like the video very much themselves. But they're doing something that nobody else is doing, which is always nice, and a sort of feel by themselves, Ian.
What do you mean they're doing something that nobody else is doing by?
Well, their own sound. I mean, a lot of
I thought you meant putting the camera on the turntable.
No, I
wasn't keen on that at all. Not the video. Yeah. It wouldn't draw me to it.
Jimmy?
I still prefer Bonnie Tyler. This is definitely going to be a hit. Definitely going to be a hit.
Bonnie.
Well, I thought the song was very sort of dreamy and the video was very dreamy. And it didn't really impress me.
I think you're very dreamy.
I think it's more of an album track than a single. And I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong.
Tim, what concept would you have if you were given the song as a video director? Would you see people running in slow motion through fields of corn? Or?
No, well, actually, I better not talk too much about the one because I've actually done one for them at one point. I don't think they liked it because they didn't ask me to do any more. Not to look bitter about it, I think, like Bobby Robson said last week on this very show about our video, he said, it's Wizzo, it did it for me. And that's what I would say.
Great, thanks, Bobby
Robson. So, generally, which is good to know. The final one, Shakin Stevens. This is his Christmas one. Christmas video and the song. Merry Christmas. Tim. That was filmed in Santa Land, by the way.
Was it? Oh, fabulous. Yeah, I've been there. Never worked with children and pullovers, that's what I say. Can I just say hello to my two mates, Jazz and Joe, wherever they are, because they'll be watching.
Maybe they're in the video. Yeah. Bonnie, briefly, are you
going to
be on Wogan on
Monday? I think that's
definitely
going to be a smash.
So you're on Wogan on Monday?
Oh, yes, I'm on Wogan Monday night.
Right. Give them our love, won't you? Right, so what do you think about the video?
I think it's the kids are going to absolutely love it, and I think it's great to have something like that over, you know, Christmas. The kids will love it. I think it's a good song too. It's a good Christmassy, happy-go-lucky song.
I think the kids will really like it. The little ones, especially them tiny, tiny babies, will really like it. And I was really pleased to see all my friends and relations in it. See all these garden gnomes? Yeah. I'll go out and meet them later on.
How does it compare to Bonnie's video?
Oh, this is still the best.
All right, Ian.
My best friend.
Not my cup of tea, but I think it will sell to the kids.
You're the oldest swinger in town, yeah?
Shut up, you. That's what we got. I remember Bonnie.
So you quite like it?
Oh, yes, I quite like it.
Quite like it. Julian, as a Bobby V fan, what do you think of it?
Well, I mean, no one can top Bobby V.
They can hear.
You know.
Well, Bonnie Holly.
I thought it was great. I love his voice. I think he's terrific. I think it'll be a huge hit. They took a lot of trouble with the video. It's all the children are banging time, you know?
Yeah, a complicated video that looks simple. I just think it's going to... I could be number one.
Could be
Shut
a number
up,
one.
You! Could be number one.
That's all. Surely a little bit of controversy nice here. There, Alvin yeah, thinks it could be a number one. Julian really likes it. He thinks it's going to be a big Christmas hit.
And we'll pass these two by.
I think it will probably be a big Christmas hit. You know, I'm not keen on this. I do like it when Shakin Stevens falls over. Because it's funny. No offence.
Exactly.
Makes service, doesn't it?
Nick, here we go next.
Well, I actually think there should be a law against things like that. I think it's absolutely horrible.
That sort of says it all for you, really.
Well, that's as nice as I could possibly say.
It's bound to be a hit, no doubt about it. It's a Christmas song, it's bound to be a hit. Shakin Stevens, no problems.
Junior.
Can I first say happy birthday to Kelly? And it's a hit.
I think it's his 20th or 21st in a row, that one. Yeah. Anyway, they've all voted that. Now then, with the obvious exceptions, a hit. Panel, thank you.
Did you get that sound, man?
Calls to Simon Le Bon and Nick Rhodes on 01811 8055. And a wee
while. Shakin Stevens video!
Right now, thanks to the pot panel, and it's down to the warehouse to say.
Welcome down to the downstairs. Oh, you! Oh, I don't believe it.
Simon, you want to do a birthday first, didn't you?
Yes, this is very important. I would like to say happy birthday to Beanie in Richmond. Beanie is also known as Isabel. Happy birthday, Isabel. And that is especially for John Rankin. That's his daughter, you see. And he roadies with us. Happy birthday, Beanie!
Happy birthday to you. What have you been up to recently? I know you've just come back from Geneva, haven't you?
Yeah.
What have you been doing over there? Just holidaying, messing around?
I was just taking a bit of... I've got to get some ideas together in the snow, actually. Because we've been with all this water's been doing me in, like...
What, video ideas for snow, or...?
No, just sort of going up into the mountains to sort of get some fresh air, really.
Do either of you do any winter sports, skiing, or...?
No.
You do?
He does.
Are you a fan of skiing?
Hey,
you're a steel hat.
I like it. I enjoy it very much. It's lovely sliding around. I haven't done it very much, though.
Well, do you do anything, Nick, at all? Sports?
Sports?
No, nothing at all.
Yeah, I play Trivial Pursuit sometimes.
You good?
It's about as sporting as I get. Well, not as good as you, Mike. Oh, no!
Right. Oh, yes.
Oh, yes!
You mentioned it. Ah! Where is Whitehall next to Northumberland Avenue? Monopoly board. Give that to Beanie for her birthday.
Beanie, right. Birthday present.
Mm. And we'll take some calls. If you want to grab your telephones, the two grey ones.
Hello.
Sophia Mirza.
Hello.
Sophia, lovely name. You're through to Nick and Simon.
I'd like to talk to Nick.
Hello, Sophia.
Hello. I wanted to ask you, what did your mum think of your makeup?
What does she think of it?
Yes.
Oh, I think she thinks it's just fine. She borrows it, actually.
Why don't you ask what I think of it?
Oh, what do you think of it, then?
I think it's just fine. I borrow it all the time.
Do you wear lots of makeup?
Simon?
Yeah, hi.
I'd like to ask you, when was the album released?
When was the album released?
Yes, so Red the Rose.
When was it released? It was
this week.
This week?
Just on Monday, I think.
Monday.
Monday.
Yeah. He's already broken his badge.
Yeah, look, man.
Oh, no.
Cheap BBC rubbish.
Well, this is a cheap question, really, wasn't it?
Thank you. Okay.
Sophia, thank you for your question.
Mike?
Yes?
Can I just have a signed autograph for Simon and Nick, please?
I would imagine so. We'll sort it out. We probably have your address, we're okay?
Right now.
Thanks.
Bye.
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 And Louise Sarrell on the line. Hello, Louise.
Hello.
Where are you calling from?
Manchester.
From Manchester. Simon Hello. And Nick, all yours.
I'd like to talk to Simon, please.
Hello, Louise, how are you?
Okay, thanks. Why did Duran Duran split up into two separate groups?
Well, we haven't actually split up. We're going to be getting back together in May to make another album. We just decided that we needed a little bit of space to experiment in a way that we couldn't with the group because the group so sort of got its own way of working. We wanted to try different ways out so that we could use them when we got back together.
Did you like going on the yacht,
Faye? I do like scared. Going on. Yeah, I was scared. I do like going on the yacht, though. Okay?
All right.
Right, thank
thanks
you.
For your question. Bye-bye. Bye. I love to Manchester. And Karen Green on the line. Hello, Karen.
Hello.
Where are you calling from?
Birmingham.
From Birmingham. Right, Nick and Simon.
Yeah, Birmingham.
Hello.
Hi.
If you could be a fly on the wall, whose house would you like to be in and why?
I was going to say, which fly would you like to be?
That's a very good question. It sounds like something that's in smash hit.
Yeah, absolutely. I know what I'd like to be in Ronnie and Nancy's bedroom.
Why?
I don't
why,
know.
Simon?
Be interesting.
Do they have to say why?
Find out who makes the decisions. That's it.
I think I'd like to be in somebody at EMI Records' bedroom, but we won't mention quite who now because he's got some things to answer.
There we are.
Okay, thank you. Can I have your autograph, please?
Yes. Whose bedroom wall would you like to be a fly on? Hello?
Hello.
Whose bedroom wall would you like to be a fly on?
John's.
John's?
John who?
Right.
Thanks for your call.
We think
thank
we
you.
Know.
Hi.
Bye-bye.
Cara English, hello.
Hello.
Hello, Cara. You through to Nick and Simon?
Hi, Cara.
I'd like to ask you, how do you see yourself in 5 years' time?
I'll be 28. And
I'll be 32.
Yeah, I don't know, really. It's difficult to say because I think that we don't really think that far ahead. But the next year we're going to be doing a Duran Duran record and hopefully we're going to be doing a tour.
Mm-hmm.
Good, thanks for your call.
Hello?
Can
I have the signed autograph, please?
We'll sort these out for you afterwards, all right?
Thanks.
Okay,
thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Take some more calls in a moment, but I know you want to get your bargain in, which you brought along, and your question.
Oh, we've got a great question.
We've got a great question. Okay, where's the camera? Quick, help.
Ah, him, you, right?
Okay. The question is, and you have fabulous prizes to win, which we are going to show you in a minute. Should we show the prizes first?
Whichever way, right?
Yeah. Show the prizes first.
Free.
One for you, and we'll show you this one.
We've got this, which is really good, let me tell you.
We've got this, which is pretty damn good indeed.
And these, which nobody quite understands, but they're really good too.
Yeah.
And this is what the record company give away to people when they send our record out. This is what your favourite magazines get.
Yeah. So you two can start up your own magazine with the help of us.
It's a good shot. I love that colour blue. It's great, isn't it?
And this.
Yes.
You wear these. These are T-shirts.
Oh, hey.
And this.
is the same as this, and this is the same as this, and this is the same as this.
All right, get your Duran Duran t-shirts, your Arcadia t-shirts, yeah? And
okay, and we think it's definitely time to ask the question now.
Definitely.
So the question is this. Arcadia was an area or a province of ancient Greece. Now, what was the name of the chief city which was founded in Arcadia at about 300 years BC?
OK, have the question again in a moment, just so you've got it. Superstore, the address, BBC TV, London W12 HQT. It should be coming up on your screen somewhere, Superstore. BBC TV, London W12 HQT. There it is. And the question, once again, Simon.
The question is, Arcadia was an area of ancient Greece. What was the name of the chief city which was founded in that area at about 300 years BC?
Marvellous. All these goodies could be yours. And time for some more talk. Squeeze maybe another one in. Louise Fodden, hello.
Hello.
Hi, Louise.
Hi.
Hello, Louise.
You've got through.
Hello, I'd like to ask them both what makes them laugh.
What?
What makes you laugh?
Oh, things that are funny.
Yeah. Tommy Cooper makes me laugh.
I like spitting images and not the 9 o'clock news.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about the rerun of Fawlty Towers?
I've seen those so many times.
I know, yes. Calling big audiences. What about you, sir?
I like little people hitting themselves over the head.
Watches too much Allah Allah.
I watch too much Punch and Judy. I like jokes. I like all kind of jokes. I really like English comedians like Tommy Cooper and Will Hay. Oh. And have you ever heard of Gerard Hofnung? Hofnung.
Do the lovely drawings?
Yes, absolutely. The story of the bricklayer. The bricklayer's story. If you can never get a copy of that record, you should do, because it's very funny. That's the bricklayer's story by Gerard Hofnung.
Thanks very much for your call.
Can I have the signed photograph, please?
Oh, I would imagine so.
Yeah. Yeah.
And can you blow a kiss to Catherine and me?
Blow a kiss?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Right, afraid that's what we've got time for. Sorry if you didn't get through. Answer to the competition on a postcard or a sealed down envelope. Simon, Nick, thanks very much for coming.
Thanks
in.
Very much, Mike.
Thank you. Okay. Now it's over to John in the coffee shop with Keith and Sarah.
Monsieur Rosiers.
Right, we have been all morning splashing paint about and it's got.